result of the Walker inquiry. It was one of Justice O'Connor's recommendations that we make this happen. And the reason is, why we're getting now into water mains across the province, like what would be in Elmville or Midland or Penetanguishene, or wherever there's water mains. Now what's happened in some of these older water systems, and you hear about it at the odd time in the city of Toronto, where there'll be a 3-foot pipe break, and it'll flood out a street, the basements are full, and they find out when they do a cutout of those pipes, that some of the pipes have got like it's a 24-inch pipe, there may be 6 inches of a heavy iron on the inside right around it. So the pipe's cut down to a 12-inch main. And it slowly builds up over the years. And the Sustainable Water Act is a bill that would slowly replace and put a program in place to make sure those mains were changed over a period of time so that that bacteria or the iron bacteria that was in some of those pipes wouldn't be a problem. The other problem they got is there's so much leakage in the system. When you've got an old water system like that, I understand that there's something like, in the city of Toronto, I could be wrong on this, something like almost 1 million liters a day leaks into the ground out of the water mains just in Toronto alone. So the idea is, you know, that's bad for the environment too. You've got good, clean, treated water leaking into the ground. And so Kaplan, I don't know why Kaplan brought that bill forward, but he had to resign from cabinet. And the next thing you know, he's got this controversial water bill that the government probably didn't want to hear anything about. But really, the government you have to support that bill, and there are problems with the bill, no question about it. The Council of Canadians, who supported Site 41 100%, they have real problems with that particular bill. But as I said in the House the other day, I actually spoke on the bill on Thursday afternoon, and I said, I paid a compliment to Maude Barlow and the gang at the Council of Canadians. I said, well, if it wasn't for them, we probably wouldn't have had nearly the action we got at Site 41, so we owe them a great deal of gratitude for their work. And you know, if we have this Catholics bill come forward and it gets called as well, then that's something that, you know, the Council of Canadians can come and say, well, this, we got a problem with this, this, and this in the bill, and AMO, the Association of Municipalities of Ontario, they have a bunch of problems with the bill as well. And you know what, but in the end, the bill is required, it is needed, and I think it's the right thing to do, but you know, it may need a number of major amendments, and that's where I know it's a long answer, Don, to my question,